check. Thank you very much, guys. Hey, was anybody here for the Christmas thing, the Christmas show thing? Woo! Wasn't that a lot of fun, that snowball fight? That was my favorite part. When Joe first called me and told me about that, I'm like, yeah, that's gonna be all right, but people are not gonna like it. Those kids that night, they just got really into that. That was really fun. We're gonna, when we were asked to come here tonight, we Peggy said, hey, why don't you do just all original stuff? Sorry about these. Okay. Yeah, my instrument changed. So we're gonna do a bunch of songs that Judith wrote. Not a bunch, we're just gonna do like a few. So, all these songs, if you like them, let her know.
Okay, well, they say write about what you know. So, I wrote about my family, mostly, this first one.
Is this a love song to me?
Yeah. So this one is about my family. This first song we're going to do, it's called Average.
If you see a three-year-old come out here, that's my grandkid.
Chocolates all alone, sitting waiting by the phone. Just the cat's for company. Their names are Buster and Fluffy. How pathetic is my life to be a schoolbus driver's wife? Just destined to be free, don't you see? Free of all prosperity.
Thank you.
We got a great time. We're so glad we got asked to play up here because for the Christmas show we had just a fabulous time practicing. Actually, we were rehearsing because we got a classically trained bassist in the band. So Brian Parmeter right over here, and what a fantastic guy! Give him a big round of applause. Joe was just talking to Brian backstage here. They were talking about how Joe used to sneak in here at night. The janitors used to let him in at night when Brian's dad was the principal here, and so Joe could practice this piano in the back room back here. So lots of history on the stage right now. Talk about history. This old guy, fabulous drummer back here. He started his first band, I think, in 1976 here in International Falls. That's pretty close, yeah, 1976. Was I born back then? Maybe not. So, and the best small engine repair guy you'll ever meet, so thanks that right there. Yeah, I didn't call you Bob Smith this time. Yeah, he's in a bluegrass band. You know, bluegrass bands don't have drums, so we're under the radar here. Don't be talking about this.
Well, these aren't really bluegrass songs.
Well, these are not bluegrass songs, I guess. But we look like a bluegrass band. We could be. We got a banjo. Yeah. So, on the banjo over there, my favorite sister-in-law, the best banjo player in between Birchdale and International Falls, and Christine Hultman. Well, maybe I shouldn't include the International Falls. Between Loman and Clemenson. And my wife, Judith, right here, who wrote all these songs tonight. Yeah. Yeah. So make a sandwich if you go to the deli. So yeah, there you go. All right.
Okay, so this next one, I wrote another one we're going to do following this one first for my son for his birthday. And then I got in trouble because that was in March of last year. And then, of course, my daughter's birthday is in August, so the pressure was on that I had to write a song for her as well. So we're gonna do her song first. And this is called The Story of Your Life. And 25 years ago, I fell in love with a little blue-eyed girl with hair so long it shone like gold. I see the story of your life unfold. I held your tiny hand in mine. Blessed be the tie that binds our heritage with roots grown deep. Breaks place and time our souls to keep. This river, it runs cold and deep. Its muddy banks are wide and steep. As the current passes swiftly by, lives of memories, sweet lullaby. You've grown across reminds me this tree and you have weathered through to now become strong-willed and true. I look with wonder across the fields and see everything I wanted you to be. A piece of earth that stood the test of time. Gentle breeze sings me a rhyme. You're like the daisy in black-eyed soup, sweet clover in the morning dew, and like the lady's slippers do. You grow with grace each spring anew. Thank you.
They did a good job, them guys. That's when you work with pros, you know you're working with pros. We're gonna do this other one she was talking about. She wrote this one for Holger, and we are trying really hard, and Lois is working with me on this, so thank you, Lois, very much, Lois Mundine. But to get Holger's band up here, and we played on this stage for, I think, at least 12 or 15, well, whenever this thing started. We were in the first radiothon on this stage, and we're trying to both Christine Sumgeary and our son Holger plays professionally on the bluegrass circuit. They actually get paid money and they make a living from playing bluegrass music.
Well, I wouldn't call them making a living.
Well, they kind of make a living. It's not like working in the mill or something.
Living the dream!
Gary's wife has a good paycheck.
Gary, he married a nurse, and Holger, he's still in college. He's doing a master's in engineering in college, so he still lives really cheaply. But Holger, he just played on a cruise 2 weeks ago, I guess, because Judith went and I stayed home to browse. No, which I was glad to do. But anyway, we're trying really hard to get those boys off here. We know for sure that Gary's going to be playing down in St. Cloud in August, so we're going to be excited about that, and maybe we can get Holger's band to Minnesota too in August, so that'll be exciting. We don't miss him, though. We're like, man, we can do this without you guys. So anyway, this song here, last year, when we were all in lockdown and all this, Judith decided, over here, 3-year-old back there. That's Christine's band. We decided that Judith wrote this song here, and we put it out on the internet and it became a instant success. We got like 50 clicks on it or something. That's a lot for us. It's called The Journey.
You have a part of it.
I know, that's why I thank you.
Thank you.
tacos. Yep. I'm
hungry. Aren't they great? I love it when people get up and dance. I'm just dancing back here.
The girls, you rocked it out there. Thank you,
Sloughgrass. That was fun. It's always a joy to have them in the house. We are, you know, I have one little trivia. Oh, the kids are good. Yeah, we play Go back there all the time. Her little guy, he's like 3 years old, he's back there and he runs up to me and he says, "Ready." I say, "Go." I'll be with. So if you heard it back, you'd
have a good time. I'm just going to tell you, you know, they sing Minnesota Hot Dish, and I have a funny little fact that they're pleased. Somebody thought it was a fact that said something about
winter increases your appetite. And I thought, no kidding. Minnesota Hot Dish, one of my favorites. We're going to have a short intermission. We're going to take just 10 minutes. Get up, stretch, go look around, catch your breath, and come back for more. We have some reading that is going to happen. We've got a little more music on the board, but please come back and listen to the second half of the show. Thank you. And
I can go downstairs for that too.
Yeah.